Here we are. It is the Escape Arts Voices podcast, and it's to celebrate 25 wonderful years of escape art. Can't quite believe it, but here we are, and it's a podcast that we're doing this with lots of wonderful people coming into the studio and sharing their experiences with us about escape art. So today in the studio, we have the wonderful Gill. How are you doing?
I'm good. Warm, but yes. Very good.
Well, it is the summer.
You it know. Is the summer, I know.
And Gill is not only a wonderful person, but she is also the Mayor of Stratford 2022-23. Isn't that right?
That is correct.
Tell us a little bit about yourself apart from being the Mayor.
Apart from being the Mayor. Where do we start? It's a long history now. 52 years. So Canadian, first Canadian mayor of Stratford, first vegan mayor of Stratford. So changing boundaries, but also teach first aid. That's my business. Mm-hmm. But I do a lot for the community. One of my goals this year is to get the whole of Stratford trained as lifesavers. It's actually how Karen and I met. We met by being community first responders together. Mm-hmm. Both of us, scary thought, us both trying to save lives.
Terrifying.
But it worked. So, yeah, and I do work with Escape. I'm a volunteer with Life Space Trust as well as a volunteer mentor. And I'm a Girl Guide leader and a Rainbow leader, a trustee for Stratford Town Trust, and obviously a town and district councillor.
Wow, and you fit that all in one day?
Somehow, yes.
Incredible.
There are 32 hours in a day, aren't there?
And 8 days a week.
Eight days a week, yeah.
That's what the Beatles said.
Exactly. So...
Oh, fantastic. So being involved in Escape Arts, have you been on any specific projects with them?
I work mainly with the youth. It's not the main Sarah, who's our youth worker, is brilliant with that. But that's where I've been supporting most of the time outside of the role of operations, health and safety and training. But we've been working, what I've been a big part of with one of my colleagues, Nick, is the refugees, the Afghan refugees. So we've been working with the young people there, and that's been such an incredible experience. They've been now in the country for, it's almost a year now, isn't it? So
August,
we've been working with them, and it's just been one of those phenomenal experiences to see them, and see them from when they first arrived in the summer, obviously during that horrendous time when they were all evacuated, to how they are now.
And have they also, obviously they're settling down in the country, but also their language barrier. I mean, it was a massive
it's helped since they arrived in the summer. Some of them did have English already, and that was very helpful. We had the children as translators, but obviously when they came, it was in the summer holidays, so there was no school. Then they started school, so it has definitely improved, so it's made it a little easier to communicate, especially with the no, yes, don't, good, the sort of very key words. But yeah, it does help, and it has improved, and you can see how they've enjoying being part of the culture of the British way of life, even while maintaining their own culture.
That's fantastic. And so you also then put them, do they go together so they can feel like, they're together as their own language as well as, being involved in the British culture?
They absolutely do. So they either go to a primary school together or the secondary school. They're both in the same schools if they're there. So it does feel like they've got communities. I think we did the Santa visit to them, and we weren't sure at Christmas if they would want that because obviously Santa's based on the Christianity side of it, and we were obviously very sensitive about it. But when we talked to the parents, they were like, no, absolutely. They were doing it at school, so when we went with the bus dressed as elves and Santa, it was a great experience. They absolutely loved it.
It's very famous, the Escape Arts Santa Grotto bus.
Oh, very much, yes.
I mean, don't know it by the end of these podcasts, well, watch out for this Christmas.
Well, I think you've also got, because Gill is also a chief elf now as well.
Yes.
So that's a really...
That was
got
my first... I got
that.
Well, I got promoted to an elf. Yep. I haven't been an elf before in that respect and until last Christmas. And so I was chief elf and driver.
Fabulous.
Yes, loved it.
Well, maybe we can elf together at
some
point.
Yes, that would be great. I would love that.
I'm music elf.
Yes, that's good. I'm definitely not.
Fantastic. And so why did you get yourself involved in escape arts?
I had such a phenomenal organisation. As I said, I got to know it when I got to know Karen as a first responder, when we were in the birthday card shop in Belcourt, when it was the old one. And my daughter was really young at the time, so she came and did some activities there. And I saw how brilliant it was with not just young people, but all people of all ages and abilities. And it's such an incredible organisation. So when the pandemic hit last year, or the year before, God, time has no meaning now, and my business as a first aid just stopped, and so I was looking for some work. And then Rachel Key, who is the CEO of Lifespace, told, Jill's actually looking for some work, have you got any? Karen literally went, hung up the phone from Rachel, said, I'm hanging up on you now and calling Jill.
It is true.
So for me, to get involved from the inside of Escape as well has just been amazing opportunity, because it's just, I know how great it is. And that's why it's also one of my charities as mayor, because as mayor I get to choose three charities, and I wanted mine to be all based around youth. And because of the fantastic youth club that has been created, that I wanted that to be part of it. It would have been a part whether it was working or not. But it's because it's one of those, and to see with the youth club especially, to see the difference it's made. You know, when we started it, when did we start? Was that November? Was it November?
No, we did the summer consultation,
and that was amazing. And going out on the bus, the old bus at that point, the old bus, the big beast. when we did that, you could see the enthusiasm for the young people. So when we finally got the H&M building, where we started with maybe getting 10 through the door, to now we get 50 through in an evening. It's just amazing. And that's why it's so vital that we keep it. We find, because we're going to lose that space at the end of the year, why we need to keep it or find another one that's similar, that we can keep it, because the children need it. The young people of our town 100% need something to do.
Mm. Yeah, absolutely. And what's your best memory so far? Have you got anyone?
Well, being the elf, that was definitely driving the bus. Yes. But I have to say that, so from inside, it's definitely working with the Afghan families. That's been incredible. As a mom for a child, so my child is, she's 15, I should say they are 15, that really struggled with anxiety and social anxiety. And the youth club has made such a difference. She's just suddenly got friends that she never had before, because that's the kind of people that are attracted to the youth club as well. You know, as well as, it's made such a huge difference. The fact she went on the coach trip last night to Daniel Lismore wouldn't have done that a year ago. So I've got two very strong feelings of it. One is from the inside, but one as a mum.
Yeah. How lovely is
it's,
that?
Yeah. That'll get me all emotional now.
But it does, because it's such a lovely organisation. It touches whether you are on the inside and you're involved, or you're outside as a parent or guardian. It's just amazing. But of course, I'm going to say that.
Yeah.
25 years has been brilliant. Do you think there's going to be another 25 years?
At least. And more, and hopefully with Karen at the helm, although I don't think she probably doesn't want to do. But
We'll push her in.
You'll be one of the VIPs.
I will be one of the VIPs. Definitely. Count me in on that one.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's such a diverse organisation that, as I said, you know, we've got the youngest people. Well, from the refugees, they're one of the youngest people we're working with is 1 year old. To what's the oldest in the VIPs?
It's our lovely Philip.
Yeah,
our D-Day veteran at 96.
Exactly, and that's what Escape's all about. It doesn't matter what age you are; there is something for everyone, and that's going to continue. Mm-hmm. And yes, 25 year plus. I want to be celebrating the 50th anniversary. I'll be a VIP with you at that point.
Could you imagine us all at that point?
Yes, but who knows where the podcast will be? Yes. It could be something completely different. Yes, we'll have to keep up with the times.
Yes.
We'll be really good silver surfers, won't we?
Oh, very good. Absolutely. Yes.
Well, it's been a pleasure to have you on Escape Arts Voices podcast today.
Thank you. It's been my pleasure as well.
And here's to some more champagne for the 25 years in the future.
Yeah. Yay!
It's recording now.
That's shut us up, hasn't it?
Okay.
You ready?
Right, yes.